Welcome to the new episode of DHTML. In this session, I'm going to discuss about the operators in JavaScript. So the operators you have already learned in C programming language. The JavaScript, I just have to just remind you the basic concept, because the major topics you have already learned in the C programming. So the syntax and the logics are the same to use all those concepts, but though it is in our syllabus, so I'll just quickly revise you, and you people have to do practicals on the basis of this concept, right? So after watching my videos, I hope you people are going to start with your practical programs from the JavaScript program list. So basically, the operators are some special symbols which are used for some operations in program. The following are the list. The one is arithmetic operator, comparison operator, which is called relational, logical assignment, and conditional, or we can say ternary operators. So the arithmetic operator, we all know that is a plus, minus, addition, multiplication, division and subtraction, and the modulo sign. Then we have plus plus and minus minus, that all these two are the incremental operator and decremental operator. The example I have discussed here, how to use this operator. So the variable a and b, the value of a is 10, b is 90. So by this way you can use the operator. The plus plus operator, let's say a is 10, and if you use a plus plus semicolon, so that means a will be now 11. Minus minus, so that will decrement by one value. So if it is 10, so it will be 9. So that is arithmetic operator, and this is the program. So how to write the program with the help of variable as well as the operator. So you can see that this is the static program. Variable a is 20, b is 10, c is equals to a plus b. Document dot write. So you want to print sum is equals to c. So let's say the value of c is 30, so it will print c. Now variable c, now that is a minus b, so then after it will print subtraction and the result of c, then multiplication and the division. So I hope you people also perform this program right in your computer and check the output. So I'll show you the output as well. As this book is very good, right? It's a Computer World Publications, and the program and the output is also given, that is sum 30, subtraction 10, multiplication is 200, and division is 2. Right, this is the arithmetic operator example, because it is written in the body tag, and the script is in head tag, so that comes first and then after the body part. Then we have the comparison operator. So the comparison operators are double equals to. This is used to compare the two operands, the variable, let's say a and b. So to compare whether a and b are similar or not, whether a and the value is similar, right? So like that way you can compare. So that is the use of double equals to. Then not equals to, that is whether the two operands are not as equal values, right? So let's say 3 and 4 are two different values, to check not equal to b, a not equal to b, so the result is true. Then triple equals to is used to compare two operands and return if both are equal. This operator compare the data type of variable and the value at the time of comparison, right? And here see, the double equals to and triple equals to, the difference is this operator ignores the data type, but this does not ignore the data type, right? This ignore the data type, of the variable and the value at the time of comparison, where this operator compare the data type variable and the value. Then the greater than symbol, A is 20, B is 10, A is greater than B. This operator is used to compare two operand. It will be return true if left operand value is greater than right operand. Similarly, we have less than. So to check which value is less than the other one, then greater than equals to check whether the values are greater or equals, and less than or equals to whether to check the values are lesser or equals, right? So this is the example. The variable is declared A20, B10. First it will check whether A is greater than B. So if yes, then it will print A is greater. If A is less than B, so it will print B is greater. Else if A equals to B, document will print A and B are same and the data type is also same, right? Else if A equals to B, so A and B are same but their data type is not same. Else you want to print that A and B are not same. Right, so this statement will print that is A is greater. Then we have assignment operator. This operator, the first is equals to symbol is to assign the value. Let's say A equal to 3. So 3 value is assigned to the variable. A equals to B plus 10. So B is 3. 3 plus 10 is 13. 13 value will be stored into the A. So that is equals to sign. Plus equals to, that means if A is 3, B is 4. A plus equals to B, so 3 plus 4 is 7, so 7 will be stored into the variable A. So now onwards, after the second statement will be, after running the second statement, the value 7 is stored into the variable A, not the value 3, right? That is changed now after running this statement. Then minus equals to, so minus the B value from the A, and the result, let's say that is 0. Multiplication into, right? So this is how we can say you can save one variable. Normally we use C is equals to A into B, so instead of that you can directly use one variable, and that by that way you can add, subtract, multiply and division of two numbers with the help of only two variables. So we have division and modulo sign as well. And this is the program, right? So the same thing, let's say A is equals to 20, B 10, C is 0, so C is equals to plus equals to A, so now C is 20, so that will print. Now C minus equals to B, so 20 minus B again 10. If you print C here, let's check the output. Yes, first sum is 20, subtraction is 10, right? Then after B into A, so 10 into A is what? 20, so yes, 200. Same way B division equals to C, B modulo 3, so it is 20 and 2. So this is assignment operator. logical operator, so that is ampersand or, right? That is and, or, and not operator. So this operator is normally we use in conditions, if conditions, and you can use this in for loop as well. Any loop, I mean while loop as well. If somewhere, if you want to use, if you want to write a conditions, right? And the next is conditional, that is the followed by question mark operator, the second part, the after question mark and before colon operator, right? So we execute the condition, turns out to be true, right? So the see the example, if C is equals to A greater than B question mark, right? So A will be the true value, B will be the false value. So if condition is true, condition is true, so A value will be print. If condition is false, B